Alright, remember this video? We are going back in. My goal then, and still now, is to build an all-purpose ESP32 shield with all the common components I use. And in that video, I actually made one. And since then, I've made a bunch of improvements, but also made plenty of mistakes, listened to your feedback, and gone through many iterations. So now, let's jump to the current version 1.4. There's a lot to cover, so let's go. Starting with the temperature sensor. The one I picked back then was a budget-friendly option, very common in cheaper modules, but it wasn't the best. Since then, I upgraded it to this one, and the price difference wasn't even big, so that was an easy decision. But if you recall, the problem I ran into was the heat creep issue. The ESP32 itself and the voltage regulator, they gave off enough heat to throw off the readings. So I learned from that and I moved the sensor far away from the heat sources. I placed it outside the main PCB area, as you can see here. And since it sticks out, the enclosure doesn't become like a mini oven anymore. I have tested it for months now and I can really see the difference. The offset is still there, but it's dramatically reduced. Another neat thing worth mentioning, I had that offset hard-coded in ESP home code, but now it's part of the UI and I can easily change it on the fly. Gotta love ESP home. The next big change is I trimmed a lot of extras. I cut down the number of LEDs from 4 to 2, the extra 2 just consumed more energy, added more heat, took up space, and really complicated the traces on the PCB. What I didn't expect after moving the 2 LEDs closer to the center, the light kinda found its way out through the motion sensor dome, creating this soft glow, turning it into a perfect diffuser that looked really nice. I was afraid it might affect the PIR sensor sensitivity, but it didn't. No false triggering so far, so that's a win-win in my book. Plus, there were roughly 8 or so smaller tweaks I did to the board as well. The buzzer was too big, so I shrank it. It's not as loud, but I can easily still hear it across the house. The human presence sensor was great. I really liked it, so I added header for it with the right orientation to be inside the PCB area and doesn't stick out like before. The screw terminals required manual soldering, so I replaced them with surface mount connectors, so now they are simply part of the assembly process and I don't have to do anything manually after I get the boards. I recently learned about the quick connector, so I added it. If you're not familiar with the quick connector, it's awesome. Go check it out. Migrated the photocells to phototransistors. They are much better, they use less energy, and the best part is they don't require a voltage divider. And bye-bye EEPROM. To be honest, I've never used it, they are way too big, and I can store things in the ESP32 itself, so I didn't see a need for them anymore. With some of the earlier changes I made, I was left with extra room on the PCB. So I added headers for a screen. There are plenty of OLED screens available to fit here. However, there is a small trade-off. When the screen is installed, it covers the motion sensor. If this is an issue, I can always use the quick connector I added earlier for the screen if needed. Last but not least, I added a dedicated voltage regulator to the shield, just to make sure the ESP board is not overloaded with the extra sensors that I am adding to the shield, and there is plenty of power to go around. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I've been a loyal user of PCBWay for several years, using their services for my DIY project and 3D prints. I'm a big fan of their $5 for 10 pieces promotion, allowing me to experiment without breaking the bank. If you share my passion for DIY project and looking to elevate your creations, consider giving PCBWay a try. You can find a link to their services down below. Now back to the video. And with all these changes, I went from this to this. Now with all the changes done, I now have a working version. So I started replacing all the messy DIY devices that I've made in the house previously. And let me give you two examples. Let's start with the smart garage door that I made years ago. I used the shield with just a reed switch to build the whole smart garage door controller. This controlled the garage door using the built-in relay, and this connected to the reed switch, and these sent live data to my home automation system. And for the software, I simply used the built-in ESP home configuration. I even used an OLED screen to show the door count with the garage. It was very easy to build, and most of the things were simply plug and play. And with the time saved, I designed a custom 3D printed enclosure, which kinda took it to the next level, and I really liked the look of it. Another surprisingly easy project to build was a room sensor. With some simple ESP home code, I had temperature, humidity, light, motion, human detection, alerts using lights and sound in my home automation. And again, with the time saved, I designed a 3D printed enclosure for different scenarios. I remember trying to build this in the past without the shield, and it was hideous, and it was messy as well, so I give up on it. I still have it, but I've never used it. But now with the shield, I have one of these in each room. It took a lot of work to get here, many mistakes, bunch of improvements, listening to your feedback, but I am very proud of how it turned out. Now I can just grab one and build on the go. I didn't make a huge batch for this shield, but whatever's left I'll put on my store. If you want to try one, you'll find everything you need there, STL files, schematic, and ESP home code. So what do you think, and what would you have done differently? I'd love to hear your thoughts. But before I wrap up, a huge thanks to my channel members and everyone who supported my work or used my store. It's because of you that I can afford to experiment, make mistakes, and share it with everyone. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching.